Cubs, are you ready?
Yeah!
Jump on board!
Ooh, look out below!
Tommy's on board!
Katie, you there?
Okay.
Shh, there it is. This is one of the jungle's most amazing creatures, the leaf bug. In order to protect itself from predators, it disguises itself as a leaf.
It's got quite a grip.
Come on, little buddy.
Nope.
I guess I was mistaken, kids. There are obviously no leaf bugs in this area.
Even a perfect...
No, they're on me!
Look at them!
I think I swallowed one.
Coming!
Pull it out!
Ben Humphrey on Hoof is a sour kangaroo, the type who's convinced she knows better than you. She made every law and enforced every rule as self-proclaimed head of the Jungle of Doom.
Why can't I play with the other kids, Mom?
How many times have I told you that the jungle is no place to act like a wild animal?
My, that Horton certainly is eccentric.
And the children are learning so much from him.
Learning to be a bunch of harebrained half-wits. And that's why my Rudy is pouch-schooled.
So while Kangaroo stood there sneering a sneer...
Horton, that was the best I've ever had in my life. What are you going to show us next?
Once again, the speck floated right by Horton's ear. And he heard it again. Just a very faint yelp, as if some tiny person were calling for help. You know what he thought? Why, he thought that there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Or even a family. It just might be so. A family with children.
I gotta go. Katie, you're in charge.
Wait! Come back!
There was this speck, and he called out for help, and I
the
was...
The speck called out for help?
Well, not the speck. I mean, that's ridiculous.
Is that what you thought I meant?
No, the speck can't call out for help. Come on, get real. No, there's a tiny person on that speck that needs my help.
Absurd. There aren't people that small.
Well, maybe they aren't small. Maybe... We're big.
Horton.
No, really, think about it. What if there was someone way out there looking down on our world right now? And to them, we're this big.
And then maybe someone else will come along and say,
Oh, there can't be people that small. And the first guy would say, are you calling me a liar? And the second guy would say, if the shoe fits, expert.
All right, fat boy, you want some of that?
What? There is nothing on that speck.
But I heard.
Did you? Really? Oh, my. Then how come I don't hear anything?
No.
If you can't see, hear, or feel something, it doesn't exist. And believing in tiny, imaginary people is just not something we do. Or tolerate here in the jungle of Newell.
Really? Because I bet if I really tried, I could find somebody who'd believe what
I'm
saying.
You will do nothing of the sort. You will not breathe a word of this lie to anyone else. Especially the children. I do not want you poisoning their minds with this nonsense. Our community has standards, Horton. If you want to remain a part of it, I recommend you follow them.
Have a nice day.
All right, then. I'll take that under advisement. Certainly appreciate your input.
I don't understand. I know I heard you. It was as plain as a nose on my face.
That's it. Maybe you can hear me.
Of course. Your ears must be tiny.
I need to speak up.
Hello!
Now, some people out there, I think I know who, may finally agree with that sour kangaroo. There can't really be people as small as a mite. Well, there can, and there are, because Horton was right.
Someday, I hope to join them. Be one of the greats. design resolutions, approve ordinances, submit budgets, and in the edible parade, I'm the one sitting on top of the giant meatball.
Someday, that can be you too, Jojo.
Someday, you'll be the one wearing the mayoral crest. You just need to. You know what I mean? Okay, good chat. I'm glad that we had this talk. That I'm continuing now by myself. Good.
Spec, shoot the breeze. We're a club. We're a group. We can take a vote on the issues.
We can be a secret society that controls the balance of power in the world.
Horton.
And no one else can join
unless they wear funny hats.
Listen, Horton. The chair recognizes Brother Morton.
I'm really happy you found this spec, and I'll... You might want to think about keeping it to yourself.
Hmm? What? Why?
Oh, you're talking to a clover. That doesn't look good.
You know what doesn't look good? You talking about the spec like the spec isn't even there. The spec never said anything bad about you. But hey, good luck with your illusion of superiority.
You know, the spec can think anything it wants about me. It's a spec.
Whoa. I see what's going on here. Morton, no matter how tight the spec and I get, the spec could never replace you.
I'm only sad that I would have to explain that at this point.
Well, that's awesome, Horton. That really helps.
Just try to keep this to yourself. I'll see you later.
Try.
Hey, Horton. What's it got there?
What? Nothing. We're not doing anything.
Do-do-dum-do-dum. We're totally alone.
Who's we?
We? What? We? Did I say that?
I just... Oh, no, I would never say that because that would imply that I was with someone and not alone.
Okay, seriously, you can't tell anybody. I mean it. If anybody finds out about this, it could be very, very bad. I'm not sure why.
We won't tell anyone. And if we do, we'll tell them not to tell anyone. Perfect.
Okay, I'm taking a bath, right? Because my skin gets kind of dry and a little bit ashy.
Well, Horton came clean about the spec in the club. How he saved it when it nearly drowned. The mayor set off on his morning commute and noticed things weren't quite the same on his route. But please don't blame Horton, for he didn't know that a small bump above...
And I dove into the water like this!
...was a big bump below.
Hey, Joe! Don't work too hard!
These luxury condos, they don't fill themselves!
Hey, look at that! I guess they do build themselves!
Okay, that happened.
Now, the mayor knew it was his job to convey the unusual things that he noticed that day. But there was one problem. Though his will was strong.
You're late.
Thank you, monsieur.
Nothing in Whoville had ever gone wrong.
With the Who's and Tannehill coming up, so let's bring this meeting to order.
Mr. Mayor, I presume you have some good news for us.
Well, it's news. I don't know if we need to go labeling it good or bad or anything like that. The thing is, I have noticed some odd goings-on in Whoville lately.
Good odd goings-on?
Well, you know, tremors, clouds swirling in the sky, and it seems to me, just to be safe, we might want to consider...
Consider what? What? Speak up, man!
Postponing the Whocentennial, all right?
To celebrate 100 years of Whoville happiness and harmony. And you want to postpone the celebration?
Well, what if Whoville's not safe?
Nothing ever goes wrong in Whoville. Never has, and never will. Do you blathering boob.
The Lusitania will proceed as planned. The mayor was merely being an idiot.
And all smiles from now on.
Girl, I got 15,000 friends already.
Spec.
Spec? What spec?
Well, I don't exactly know how to tell you this, but
you're living on a spec.
Well, I hate to disagree with you, oh voice from the drainpipe, but I live in Whoville.
Well, then, Whoville's a spec.
Right, okay, seriously, who is this? Is this Bert from accounting?
No, this is Horton. I'm an elephant.
Okay, Horton, fake name, where are you?
Well, from where you're standing, I guess I'm in the sky. Compared to you, I'm enormous, which is saying something, because I've slimmed down quite a bit. I swim. Your whole world fits on a flower in my world.
Oh, man, this is even pushing it for you, Bert.
Don't believe me? Watch what happens when I put you in the shade.
This is absolutely impossible.
Light. Don't you see?
We're in the middle of some kind of amazing cosmic convergence. Two vastly different worlds, miraculously crossing paths.
Mine colossal, yours minuscule. Yet somehow we've managed to make contact.
If you think about it, it's pretty amazing.
Is everything okay down there?
You tell me. You're the one holding this back.
I'm the one holding this back. I'm the one holding this back.
Don't you worry, Mr. Mayor.
Hold, please.
What did all of this mean? The mayor hadn't a clue. So he ran to the office of Dr. LaRue, the brainiest name on the staff at WU.
Dr. LaRue? Oh, this is crazy.
Oh, Mr. Mayor.
I don't know. Hey, you know, I was just wondering, if our world were, say, a tiny speck floating through space, how would we know?
Well, why would you ask something like that?
Oh, no reason. No reason at all. I don't even remember. Yes, I do. You know what? Some guy was talking to me. Not an elephant in the sky. A guy on the ground.
There would be several ramifications.
Good ramifications?
A tiny speck.
Well, yeah, tiny speck.
Floating around. Well, we have inexplicable tremors, dramatic changes in the weather, and if we do eventually achieve some sort of stability.
That's right. Oh, that's right. Oh.
Horton!
Horton is busy right now.
You are joking.
That's me.
Oh, we're doomed.
Listen, Horton, turns out I need your help a little bit. Apparently, if that speck keeps moving around, our whole world could be obliterated. So, I need you to find us who's a safer, more stable home and fast.
No problem, Mr. Bear. Let's see. Wow, that's a nice view.
Hello, is everything okay? What's going on up there?
Fight this
fight, Horton?
Because I promise you it will get very ugly very fast. And you need to ask yourself, do I really want to put myself through all this? For a clover? Take it from me, Horton. You don't. So hand it over.
No! I can't give it to you! There are people on this spec. Granted, they're very small people, but a person's a person, no matter how small.
Huh. You just crossed the line, Horton, and I'm gonna make you pay. That Horton is a menace. He has those kids using their imagination. It's sick.
All right, I gotta get this spec up to the top of Mount Newell ASAP. Whatever that means. Probably act swiftly, awesome pachyderm. I mean, how hard can that be?
Death.
This looks kinda precarious. Well, no need to worry. Obviously, when they build a bridge like this, they take into account that elephants will be crossing here. All right, feeling good? I'll just get... Sense of purpose.
Collection, and then stop looking at my arm. Put away Holly's light bulb collection, and then you know what? Just take care of anything that might break or shatter. Okay, take a good long look. Got it? Somewhere it can't fall on us and crush us in our sleep.
What is going on?
Hey, hon. Did you ever get the feeling that you were being watched?
Yeah. Sure. I suppose.
And then you get the feeling that maybe that thing watching you is a giant elephant. Actually a tiny speck, and that the elephant that I talked about earlier is carrying it around on a flower, and you realize that if you tell anybody, they think you were crazy, but you still feel a responsibility to keep everyone safe. You know that feeling?
You know, I'm gonna have to say no. Do you know that feeling?
Ah, oh, no. Good. Wow, I am beat. Time to hit the hay, I guess.
Sweetheart, I know you're under a lot of stress. And if you're seeing elephants and flowers, then fine. The world.
The end of the world.
Horton the mayor. Horton the mayor. Come in, mayor. Over.
Horton? Oh, I get terrible reception here.
How about this? If I get up real close, can you read me?
Yep. Roger that. Are we at that safe place yet?
Almost. I'm pretty sure the worst part's over. This is your elephant speaking. Just sit back, enjoy the ride, and we'll have you to Mount Newland no time.
Who's that? Is there someone else there?
Well, that's my wife and kids.
You have a family.
I do indeed. A beautiful wife, 96 daughters, and one son.
Oh, busy guy.
Then we all share one bathroom. You know how that is.
Yeah, don't I know it.
Bathroom?
Ned? Sweetheart, you know you're on the roof, right?
Please.
What's that? No, you need to go to bed. Daddy's having a breakdown. Ned, what are you up to now?
I was just about to put the kids to bed when I got off the roof. And that's what happened.
Daddy?
Yes?
Can I have a glass of water?
Of course. Okay. Just the person I wanted to see. Yeah, I realize that we have not been seeing eye to eye lately, and most of it is my fault.
That's true.
You know what I've been trying to do? I have been trying to impose my vision of your future on you. Let me make this perfectly clear. Jojo, you can be whatever kind of mayor you want to be. Hands-on, strong and silent, outspoken, it's up to you. Well, good. I feel so much better. I am expecting big things from you, young man. Big things! All right. Good night. Good stuff. Good talk.
Then Jojo snuck out feeling lonely and sad, and tragically misunderstood by his dad. Such a late hour. Up to Whoville's abandoned star-studying tower. A place where the boy felt contented, free. A place he could be what he wanted to be. And what was inside there, I'd say if I could. But up above, the kangaroo was up to no good.
Can we come out now, Mom?
No, Rudy. Stay in your room. Stay inside. Mr. Vladikov! You're busy, but I need your help. It's Horton. He's become obsessed with a clover, and he actually thinks there are little people on it. I want that clover destroyed.
Sure, what a big deal this is. For you, bro.
I'd do it myself, but being a lady, I prefer not to get my hands dirty. But I hear you have no problem with that.
No. No problem. It's easy. But I will only do this for a price. In exchange for a brand new pair of... No. This. Little kangaroo.
Mom!
Quiet, Rudy. Mommy's thinking it over.
Huh. Well, thanks. But on second thought, I think I'm going to have the Wickersham brothers take care of this for me.
Yeah, of course, Wickersham. I mean, they're a classy operation. You know, they don't... Wait, no! You can't Wickersham!
No. The Wickershams would be perfect for this job.
But they're monkeys! It's not scary!
Thanks anyway. Maybe next time.
Wait! Here's what I will do to precious clover. I will take it. I will crush it. And I will devour it. Bigger than it look. One second. Holy moly. Hang on. Then I regurgitate it. Then I'm gonna devour it second time. So two times devoured.
Sounds nice. But I think
I do all gratis. That's free, bro. What do you think?
Deal.
Yes, score. Thanking you. You won't regret.
Good.
down here. It's happening. It's snowing. In the middle of summer. It's the end of the world!
Hold on, Mayor. I think I know what your problem is. Snack, but they tend to linger. Uh-oh. Hang on, Mr. Bear. I may have to put up a fight. Frightened elephant can be very dangerous. All right. You've calmed down the thunder, buddy. You hungry for trouble? I'm an all-you-can-eat sound man. Take a bite.
I hate running.
Morton,
don't do that.
Trouble! Wait, did you hear that? No, I'm here. Okay, listen, no, go. Kangaroo has gone nuts. Bananas. She's telling everyone that you should be kicked out of Newell.
She said that? I thought we were friends.
Word is, she's gone to Vlad.
Vlad. I know two Vlads. Is it the bad Vlad or the bunny Vlad that makes the cookies?
Yeah, Horton. She's sending you a bunny with cookies. I think we can assume it's the bad Vlad.
Yeah, that's a good call.
So, unless you're cool with giant razor-sharp claws ripping the flesh off your body, I get rid of the clover.
I can't. I promised the mayor. I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. And an elephant's faithful 100%.
Please, for me, just as one. Be faithful 99% of the time. I've never got 99% on anything. I think I'm awesome. So come on.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant.
I'm not going to say it. You can do that all day. It's not happening. An elephant's faithful 100%.
That's right. That's my code. My motto. Thanks for the warning.
Motto? Okay.
Let's watch the skies. Keep watching the skies.
Mayor, you need to get everyone underground. Now.
I don't want to sound the alarm. There's a good possibility we may be attacked by a giant carnivorous bird.
What? There's a small chance it could be a bunny with cookies, but I wouldn't count on it.
No, they are formidable.
There? Are you there?
Yeah, no, that's a great idea. It's just, in order to get everyone mobilized, I'd need the okay of the city council, and they never listened to me. I've been called a boob several times. I can't do it.
You have to talk to the mayor. Okay, listen.
Bad Black!
That is definitely not a bunny. Lost him. Meant to lose him, and I lost him.
What happened? The bird?
Yeah, it attacked. attacked me. Mayor, your people are in danger.
Huh. You know what? I'm gonna do it. I am going to go out there and tell them what is going on.
Perfect.
Now, quick, get going.
Basement in the attic.
The science museum is history.
The lost and found is missing.
Can we call it, Mr. Mayor?
I'm declaring a state of emergency.
Don't worry. Don't worry. The mayor is just being a moron.
Wait. Whoville is in terrible danger. Everyone needs to get down to the underground storage area immediately.
Fine. Let's do this democratically. Who wants the joy and glory and festivity of the Whocentennial to proceed as planned? Yeah! And who, like the mayor, thinks it would be better to spend the Whocentennial in an underground storage area? Yeah!
Wait, you've got to listen to me. Our whole world could explode. Much more quickly! And our world wouldn't make that noise.
The people have spoken, Mr. No one supports you.
Horton believes me.
Horton? Who's Horton?
Horton is a giant elephant in the sky. Don't bother looking, he's invisible. And he's the one risking his life to get Whoville, which, by the way, is a speck on a clover, to safety! I can prove it! Horton's voice comes out of this horn! Horton! The Who's gathered in Town Square. Let them know you're there.
Gee, kind of a high pressure situation. Wow, I am really drawing a blank here.
I know.
Horton, we're waiting. Time to show everyone that you exist and, by extension, what a non-boob I am. Wait! Everyone, look at the... What do you think that that means?
It means... Obviously, let the kite-flying race begin!
No!
clover by clover by clover, he found that the one that he sought for was just not around.
Mayor? Hello?
And by noon, poor Horton, more dead than alive, had picked, searched, and piled up 9,005.
Hello? Sorry to bother you. Nobody?
Knock, knock. This is where you take. Who's there? If there were any, who's there?
All day he looked on and on, till his hope was almost gone.
No, 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 please, no! Oh, this isn't fair!
But wait, could this one be the one? Was all his searching finally done? Ah, yes, for this was the hour. Horton had found it on the 3 millionth flower.
Mayor! I found you! Mayor? Are you there? Mayor?
Sally.
You exist! Oh, this means my husband isn't crazy. Hooray!
And a few of my daughters, Haley, Holly, Hooli, Hilda, and Henny.
Hi!
And here is Miss Yelp, my loyal assistant. And here's Dr. LaRue.
You shamed us!
And Bert from accounting. And Mrs. McGillicuddy. And Mr. Farfugan from the Klugen Farfugan. And the old man in the bathtub.
Let's not overwhelm the poor fella. He's never gonna remember all these names.
Well,
try my best.
Sally, Chairman, Hallie, Hooli, Holly, Hilda, Hetty, Miss Yell, Dr. LaRue, Bert from accounting, Mrs. McGillicuddy, Mr. Farfugan of the Clinton Farfugans, and isn't there an old guy in a shower?
Bathtub.
Oh, yeah. We're all here, Horton, and we all believe in you.
Wow, that's awesome. And it's a responsibility I do not take lightly. I promise you a future that is safe, sound, and stable. We will create a world where every Jew is endowed with 3 inalienable rights to be determined at a later date. And we will put us back on Mount Noor before the end of this decade.
Oh! This is an elevated present. Oh my goodness!
You should have been seeing me. I really let the elephant have it. I chase him, I torment him, I break him into a million little elephant pieces. It was thing of beauty, really. My best work. Classic blend.
And the clover?
Clover is finished. No way in a million years, Horton, find it. Read my beak. Clover is done forever.
I just saw Horton and he is
way of life is under attack.
And who's leading that attack?
Horton!
Whoa, wait a minute. This is Horton we're talking about. You know him? He wouldn't hurt a fly. Except for that fly city he sat on. But he didn't do that on purpose.
Shut up, Mouse.
Yeah, that's weird. Man, my brownies are burning. I gotta go.
Are we going to let troublemakers like Horton poison the minds of our children?
Not the children!
When Horton tells our children about worlds beyond the jungle, he makes them question authority, which leads to defiance, which leads to anarchy!
Yeah! Horton must be!
In that stack!
No, we have to do something!
For the children!
For the children!
Say it isn't true. Go ahead. Rope me. Cage me. Do whatever you want. But there are people on this spec, and they have a mayor who has 96 daughters and one son named Jojo, who all share a bathroom, whatever that is. And even though you can't hear or see them at all, a person's a person. No matter how small.
Was beautiful, Horton. Rope him! Cage him! Burn that speck in a pot of boiling diesel! That boil!
They don't believe we're here.
We've got to make some noise! We are here! We are here! We are here!
We are here! We are here! We are here!
Come on! Everybody!
We are here! We are here! We are here!
Yeah.
bazookas and blasted great toots. And clarinet zoopas and boopas and flutes.
Ask for a better son.
Get that clover. Anybody, take it from him. You did it, Mayor. You did it. We did it!
Hi, Vlad.
shouldn't.
But...
Nice touch. Oh, I'm a mess with this, right? I'm emotional. Here come the water slide.
There's so many people to thank. The good people of Newell who put me in a cave.
Well, not right by me. He hid the bushes. Sending me good thoughts. He's gone.
Dude, you are a warrior poet.
And most of all, I'd like to thank the mayor of Whoville.
Who believed in me from the beginning.
Oh, Horton. We're going to miss you.
Do without you, Horton.
Don't worry. I'll always be around.
And even as I wander,
on
in sight,
you're a candle in the window
on a cold, dark winter's night.
Beautiful metaphor.
And I'm getting closer than I ever thought I might.
Ooh, that's a little high.
Baby, I can't fight this feeling anymore.
And if I have to crawl upon your floor, come crashing through your
ring, baby.
There's not this feeling in me.
And so, all ended well for both Horton and Hooves, and for all in the jungle, even kangaroos. So let that be a lesson to one and to all. A person is a person, no matter how small.
Words. Oh, that felt so good. Cathartic!